Hello there, this is John Miller with Alara Systems. Today I wanted to discuss helixes and coils utilizing 3ds Max and a third-party plugin called TurboSplines. We'll also be using world space modifiers and splines to create these effects. You can utilize these in pipes that you want to make, rope strands showing coils or wires, or just fancy ways to do some motion graphics. All right, let's go ahead and get into that. For this tutorial, we'll be using 3ds 2017. Right away, let's go ahead and get a line spline going. Now, we don't have to make this fancy. The way we're going to utilize this is basically just a way for us to get some curves along. So this is just a foundational line. Doesn't need to be anything fancy. I'm just gonna go ahead and make some quick points here. And then I'm gonna just move them around until I get something that I'm happy with. All right, that's looking pretty good. Now at this point, I'm gonna wanna go ahead and select it and then pick Turbo Splines. Turbo Splines is really useful. It has all sorts of things you can do. You can make splines that coil around other splines. You can turn those into renderable properties. You can then slide cylinders, cubes, ribbons along those splines. You can do all sorts of neat stuff with it. For now, I just want to use it to create some curvy lines along this spline. So I'm just going to play with some settings here until I get what I'm looking for. Just basically something that has some curves. The way I can do this is go to TurboSplines and select the Helixator. And what that's going to do is it's going to allow me to choose a spline. And then I can then choose from these settings, such as turns, which will say how many turns this is going to rotate along the spline, or start radius, which is going to be the size of the radius. So in this case, I'm just going to go with something small, because all I want to do is get a rough curve off of this, because this is going to drive the actual spiral that I put along the sinus. So it's just a quick way to get some chaos in the scene. So not feeling that, so I'm going to go ahead and increase the radius a bit. And that's getting there. Let me make one more. So I'm gonna go ahead and increase the turns, make it 3. Yeah, that's getting closer. What I'm really trying to achieve is something large and swath, but let's just go ahead and use this. I have another way of getting where I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and make a couple there, and then I'm going to then grab the other spline and make one more along it. Yeah, I'm feeling that. So now I can grab the foundation. I can rotate it or move it, because it's going to keep it selected. It doesn't matter where you have it. And yeah, there we go. So now I can just grab that foundational spline, rotate it, and then add one more. Yeah, there we go. So I have a plan to simplify this, but for now, this is just a quick way of doing it. Variation also allows you to use the same spline you did before, but it adds more of a turn and chaos to the spiral that you're creating. So yeah, that's what we're gonna go with. I'm gonna go ahead and delete that line, no longer need it. And in this case, I think we can go ahead and begin. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all the splines, and I'm gonna use a tool that's now part of 3ds Max 2019 called Normalized Spline 2, which was initially created by Boomer Labs. And what I can do with this is just show the total knot counts and then reduce them. So what used to be a crazy chaotic spline is now simplified. And I'll just do this until I get the shapes that I'm feeling. And then when we're done with that, we can just say, leave that in the modifier stack so we can come back to it later if we want. And this will give us a strong foundation for adding the helixes to in just a second. What we want to do now is create a straight line. This straight line is going to be the foundation that we put the coils on initially, which we'll then follow up and put a world space modifier on for path deform. The reason we do this is it allows us to get a center point for the coils, and they're not skewed in any way. So to do this, you're going to go to the same way we did before, and you're gonna choose the spline. In this case, it'll be a grow line, and you'll just say create helix on it. That's going to go ahead and give us a spiral. It's nice, clean. It's exactly what we're looking for. So now what we can do is, just to make sure, we want to make sure that the object is going to have its pivot centered. So we're going to go ahead and go up to its pivot, center to object, and we're good. This is important when putting on the path deform, so when we rotate along it, it'll rotate along the center of the axis rather than on any other point, which would offset it. So now what we can do is we can go up to the modifier list and we can select the path deform, world space path deform in this case. So I'm going to go ahead and select that real quick. Then I'm going to pick the path, move to path, choose the correct axis, in this case it's X. Check that out. Now we have this coil alongside of this. So now I can copy that world space modifier and I can put it on all the other instances. Make sure we don't paste instance though, because we're going to need them to be there separate, because we're going to need to rotate them separately. So I'm going to just go ahead and paste the world space modifier on all of them, and then I'm going to retroactively go back and move to path so that they're all in the same spot. Perfect. Now check it out. So I want to go ahead and make this relative to the length of the spline. So I'm just going to go ahead and make the stretch right. Awesome. So now what I can do is I can come in here and I can change the rotation, and that will rotate it slightly so that it'll add a gap, much like screwing a screw through a tap and die set. So now that we have that one done, gonna go ahead and move this one up, and it looks like I just need to do one more spline to have that even coil all the way across, which means I can eliminate the other two since I made six splines total. There we go. Nice. So what we can do, now that we have all of these splines done, we can then select all of them and put an X form on them. And what's going to allow us to do is basically, on the same spline in the same local space, is grow it, shrink it, but the beauty is it'll still be in the same location. So we can do all sorts of stuff, and then we can start quickly getting variation. So I'm going to go ahead and add an X form to all of these splines, the clones that I just made. And make sure the gizmo when doing this is in local space, and then check it out. When I grow it along X, it grows the entire thing in the same space. As you can see, you can get crazy real fast. You can have these shapes cloned, put them on other splines, grow them, shrink them, add more. The variations will stack on very fast once you get the initial pipeline done. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up the other five splines, and then we'll come back to the rest. All right, with that done, now we just need to prepare them for turbo splines so we can have some renderable objects slide along these paths. To do so, we need to prepare them, as the world space modifier will not allow other world space modifiers to be on top of them. There'll be this major offset. So to do so, we need to collapse the world space modifier in them down. To do so, just select the spline that you want to do it, the world space modifier, and then say collapse two. Not collapse all, as it'll still sit there. Now in this case, because of how many splines I have, this is going to be a bit tedious, but all things take time. So I'm going to go through this process, get all of these ready, and then we'll finish up with the last phase. Coolio! Now the fun is going to begin. I mean, we've been having a blast, but this is where all the hard work pays off, because we're going to get to actually see 3D geometry. So pick the paths you want and add them using turbo splines. Just throw them in the add paths, choose cylinder for the mesh type, and build geometry. And check that out! Bam! You now have 3D geometry on splines! You can choose to grow the sides, add segments, height. There's a lot of control on this. So if you want a high polygonal model, you can do so. It's awesome. So the other thing we want to do is, add more splines, but first we want to take the other splines out. So just select all the ones in the current stash there, hit that little paper X, add the ones you have selected, do the same thing we did, build geometry, and voila, same thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and do these to the rest of the splines, show you guys how we're gonna animate, moving them up and down, using the path percent, which is very similar to world space modifier, path deform, it'll slide up and down. I'll show you, let me just go ahead and move it up and down, and then we'll go from there. Cool. So I went ahead and built a camera. I need to animate it real quick just to make sure it looks good. And yeah, I think we're all right. So what I want to do here is I want to get all of these shapes to animate. So let me just move the camera in the right place. All right, so I'm going to select these and then I'm going to choose path percent with auto key on. And now, like, if I have 0 to 100 selected and I choose one all the way to the path off the screen and with the path all the way on, slide between, as you can see, it coils across the entire guide wire. So I'm gonna do the rest with these and get these all set up. Same process following along, just, there we go. Just path up and down, path percentage key. It really takes care of all the minutiae. All you really need to figure out is what you want it to look like. So once you have that all figured out, you can animate. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish up the rest, and then we'll come back and I'll show you how to do some really easy offsets. Cool, so check it out. All of these are now done and animated. Now, all of them go from 0 to 100. From the beginning it starts, from the beginning to the end, they all have the same motion, but I want to offset them. So what I can do is select one and just drag the key. Then I can select the other, drag the key, and just make it random. Like, I'm not looking for anything specific. I just want them to all move at a different pace. That way when they all coil across, they'll do this just weird sporadic thing that no one can guess. Let's go ahead and scale them up. I mean, it's all about randomness. So we're not trying to match anything. We're just trying to make it not uniform. And you can, like, as you can see, you can get there real fast just by selecting some, moving some keys, scaling those keys. It's all in the system. And 3ds Max allows you to get there real fast. So I'm gonna go ahead and animate all of the splines, and I'll show you how to do a quick build from there. Cool, these are all done. So the thing is, I feel like 0 to 100 is a bit small. It happens really fast. So I think I'm gonna double it and go to 200. So I'm just gonna drag the timeline here until it gets to 200. And I'm gonna select all of the geometry. Oh, I got some turned off. Let me turn those back on. Cool. So now I'm going to select all of this geometry, and then all the keys are gonna show up on the timeline. I didn't grab all of them. Let me go ahead and scale, undo that. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all of these keys, then I'm gonna scale them up to 200. And bam, that's all I'm looking to do. Now, it's just super easy. Select the camera, make sure the camera movement goes all the way to 200 as well. And now we have our scene. There it is. So that's pretty much it. TurboSplines is really powerful. There's just some forethought in what you want to do using the splines. Always remember that world space modifiers do not work well together, but you can get some really awesome sporadic geometry that just coils, does all sorts of funny stuff, and it doesn't really take much time at all. So thanks for tuning in. We will have more tutorials coming your way. Hope you enjoyed.